Hello friends, welcome to H2Zone Solution and Production. Today we are going to discuss how we can install Symfony on your machine, and also we will discuss how we can make new project in Symfony. After that we will discuss how we can make a entity model which will make a class for us without type manually. We will use command which will automatically create class for us, and after that we will run some database migration command which will make database for us, and also it will make table for us. After that we will make a RESTful API. For that purpose I already make a project which I have uploaded on GitHub. You can download this project and utilize for your application. Okay, let's start. First go to Google and download Symfony, and after that download the respective setup for your machine. Like I have already downloaded Symfony in my Windows machine, so I am going to create a new project using this command. And if you don't have Symfony in your machine, you can also run this command using Composer. And if you want to make a full project, then you will use this command. In my case I am going to develop microservice API, that's why I am using this command. But if you don't want to install Symfony in your machine, you can also use these commands. Okay, let's start. I already make a sensor monitor folder in my www folder, so it will make a sensor monitor API folder in this folder using this command. I am going to open command prompt and navigate to this path, and after that I will run this command. You can see that it made a one folder for us. It will take some time to download some packages, prereq libraries for us. So for time saving, I am skipping this installation and downloading part. Okay, my project is ready. Even I made some classes and entity in my controller folder and also in my entity folder, which I already uploaded on GitHub repository. You can use these files. Okay, let's open this folder in phpStorm. Okay, my phpStorm already loaded this project. You can also open this project via this option. Okay, now I am going to show you that how we can make a new entity. Go to source and go to entity. In entity directory we already have some classes which I already made for testing. I am going to make a new entity to show you how we can make new entity using this command, php bin console make entity. Go to command prompt and ensure that you have in your working directory. This is my working directory and it is navigate to command prompt. I am just going to type this command, and it is asking which entity or database table which you want to create. I am going to make it as post type, or you can say that post category. So I am setting it as post cat, which is a post category. And in post category table I want to create a field, and note that by default id field will automatic create for us. So I am going to make a next field which is title, and I am going to set its type as string, and this string is equivalent to the varchar. And if we will not set any field length, then by default it will be set to 55. Like this string is the default data type. So I am going to press enter, and it is asking, do you want to set this field title as nullable or not? So I am going to set it as no. For next field, I am going to make it as creation date time. And if you are not sure
data type,
so you will press question mark, and it will show the all data type. Like for int, we will use integer, but in this case I want to use date time, because I make a field name as creation date time. That's why I am going to set it as date time. Press enter, and set is as nullable no. And they are asking, do you want to create any other field for this table? I am going to set as enter, because I no more want to add any new field for this table, and my one class is ready. See this, this is new class which is automatically created using these commands. See this, it already created ID for us, and also it make a field name as title, creation, date, time, and also it will make getter and a setter for every field for us. Now if we will run database migration command, it will automatically create a table post category for us with these fields. But before that, I want to show how we can create a new table and make a foreign relationship with this table. For that purpose, I am going to again run this entity command, and I will make a new table name as blog post. And for field name, I am going to set it as post title, and data type as string 255 the label, and set post length as integer. And now I am going to make a relationship of this post category with this new entity. But before that, I am going to set the name of this field as post get link, and put the question mark, and it will show the relation. So I am using many to one relation, because many posts will have same type of category. So I am using many to one relation, and it is asking what class should this entity be related to. So I am using as post get. Use the same spelling, post get, and it is asking, do you want to allow nullable? Yes. Nullable, yes. I'm saying no, I want to set immediately. And it asking that it will automatically create some functions to access and update blog post. So I am going to set this as yes. And so by default it will set blog post field name. I am going to press enter. And it is asking, do you want to cascade or not? So I am going to set it as no. And it is asking, do you want to create a new field? I am going to set no. For no, I am going to hit enter button, and it will automatically create a new class for us, which is blog post, which has field like post title, post length, which is integer, and it is string. And it will also create a new relation with the post category, and in post category it will also add some new parameters. Like you can see that it is as added one to many relation for the post category link. And also it created some collection related to blog post, and also add some new functions which is linked with this blog post entity. So they will create everything for us automatically, and this is a blog post table in which they add every getter and setter automatically for us, and also it make a category link which is linked with this post category table. Now our entities are ready to test. Now we want to make automatically in database. For database setting, you should ensure that you have some setting in your env file. In my case, I am using MySQL, so I am setting its port, its local IP, local host IP, and you can set any database name here. It will automatically create for you. In my case, I am using SensorMonitorDB. For testing purpose, I already make one database. I am going to delete it to show you that how things work. Now you can see that our database is no more in this list. So now I am going to run migration command, but before run the database command, we should have some prereq packages. And also, if you want to use RESTful API for Symfony, you should also ensure that these packages should install in your machine. You should run each command one by one in your running directory. I already installed these packages, so I am not going to run all these six packages. So you should run these six packages one by one while running these commands. If you will show the error of any prereq library after these six commands, I again run this command because it requires some these packages as prereq. So you should run this command again after these commands. Okay, I am considering that you install all these six packages. Now run this database creation command, and Doctrine is the ORM pack library, so it will run after installing ORM package. So I am going to run this command. And it will create database for us, which we will set in our environment file. You can see that it is created new database for us without any table. For the table, we want to create these blog post and blog category table. We will run this command and ensure that you should have not any migration in migration folder. What is migration? The migration is when we will make any new classes, entity classes changes, then new migration will create here. And if we will run migration, then every new changes will append in our database. So you can say that migration is directly related to your database schema or design. Okay, now run this migration command. It will make new migration in migration directory. You can see that it create new migration. See this, it is created new migration which has all table which we are listed in our entity folder, like blog post, blog category, and it already created all the field for us. Okay, now run this command. This command is just create new migration. Now we want to run migration to add columns and tables in our database. For that purpose, I am going to run this command.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.